Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today's episode, we're going to be talking about VR and how you can get up to 30% more FPS with no loss in visual clarity. Now, I was amazed when I heard about this and even more astonished when I got to use it. So if that excites you, then stay tuned for today's episode of 2020 Flight Simmers. Okay, so let's get right into this. Now, the first piece of software that you're gonna need for this is the OpenXR developer tool for Windows Mixed Reality. Now, don't worry, this video is not on this particular tool. This is gonna be something completely different. But many people may not have this, so I just wanna stress that you need to get this. If you do not have this, it's very, very simple to get. All you need to do is go down here to the start bar and then open up the Microsoft Store. Once the Microsoft Store is open, then all you need to type in is OpenXR, and you'll probably see the OpenXR developer tool pop up. Left click on that and then hit the download button. Now you've got the OpenXR developer tool. All right, great. So now that we've got that downloaded, we can just go ahead and minimize that. Next, we can take Microsoft Flight Simulator and we can get that off the screen as well. Actually, I'm just gonna go ahead and close out Microsoft Flight Simulator. We're gonna need to anyway. Oh, and by the way, if you're new to the channel, make sure you go down below and hit that subscribe button and tick that little bell. If this video does help you out today, smash on the thumbs up button. It really helps us get found by viewers like yourself. All right, so the next piece of software that we're gonna need, links will be down in the description, comes from this fabulous developer named Mbuchia. I hope I pronounced that right, but I probably didn't. But a big thanks goes out to this developer. So once you click on the link that I have down in the description, it will bring you up to this page. Now, once you're here, you can click on the instructions here on the GitHub, and that will give you some basic instructions on how to use this application. And don't worry, we're going to go over all of this during our installation process. Now, once you arrive on this page, you may be wondering, well, where are the downloads? Well, you need to come right down here to the Assets tab and then give that a left click. And when you do, it's going to open up three different files, but the one that we're mostly concerned with is the OpenXR NIS Scaler tool. Now, as you can see in the description here, this is the NVIDIA scaling tool, but it is utilized for VR. Now, many people already may be familiar with this particular tool in the NVIDIA control panel. Now, on the NVIDIA control panel under the Manage 3D settings, it is the very first option here, and that is the image sharpening. But this application that you have just downloaded doesn't really have anything to do with this setting in the NVIDIA control panel. This setting is for your monitors only. I just wanted to show you where you could find it, and if you want to test this out for your monitors, go right ahead. But for this video, we're going to keep it just directed towards VR. Okay, so now once you've got this up, we need to click on the OpenXR NIS Scaler tool. So we just give that a left click, and it will populate down here in the lower left-hand corner of the browser. Once it is finished downloading, we can just give that a left click, and then you may get this little pop-up here that says, hey, we're protecting your PC. Well, don't worry, just click on more info, and then click down here on the Run Anyway tab. And once you do, you're gonna be welcomed with a beautiful setup wizard, and we're just gonna walk right through the setup process. So the first thing we need to do is hit the Next button, and we've got some things here that we can read. Once you're done, you can hit Next, and then you're going to select whether this is for everyone that uses the computer or just yourself. Now, here's also where you can select the location that you may want to put your scaling tool. So just take note of the location of the folder because we're gonna need to go there in the future. So now all we need to do is just click the Next button at the bottom. And now the installer is ready to install. We can hit Next one more time, hit Yes, and it has now been successfully installed into our PC. Now we need to do is hit the close button, and there we go, we're all set up. Okay, so now we need to verify that it has been installed into our system. To do that, all you need to do is open the OpenXR Developer Tool for Windows Mixed Reality, and we need to make sure that we are connected to our headset. All right, I just got my headset on. We have refreshed, and now we are linked up to the headset. Now here's where we're going to verify that the installation took place. Over here in the system status, when you click on that, it's got a bunch of different information that's going to populate here. But the main thing that we're concerned with is all the way at the bottom where it says API layers, you should have a file that says November NIS scaling tool. You want to make sure that it says it right there in the API layers. That lets us know that it has installed successfully on your PC. Great. Now over here on the developer settings, there's a couple things that you need to make sure that are set properly for everything to work in Microsoft Flight Simulator. Now, the first thing that we want to do is go ahead and set your render scaling. Now, if you have just downloaded this for the first time, the custom render scaling will not be ticked. You want to make sure that you check that, and then you want to set your custom render scaling to 100%. So that goes for the same inside of Microsoft Flight Simulator. You want to have the render scale in VR also at 100%. So now we can go ahead and minimize that once again. And now we need to find the image scaling tool. Remember where I told you, make sure that you take note of where that image scaling tool was going to be installed. For me, it was going to be down in the Windows directory. And then we're going to look for the program files directory. And then if I scroll down, I should be able to see the OpenXR NIS scaler tool. Great. So now we want to double click on that and open the scaling tool. Now, the part that we're going to be concerned with here is we want to get to the configuration tool. There's a great config user interface, but we just need to get to it first. So up here at the config UI, if you left click on that, and then all the way down at the bottom, you'll see the application file. You can take this application file, left click, hold, and drag it down here to your taskbar, and then release it, and then it will post it right down here for you. Also, you can right click on this, and then create a shortcut to where then you can place it right on the desktop. All you have to do is click yes, and then it will place that shortcut right on the desktop for you. So before we're going to open Microsoft Flight Simulator, let's open that NIS scaling tool, and let's show you how it's going to work. So all I need to do now is just click on that scaling tool, and then we're just going to hit yes to the prompt. Once that tool populates here, if you click on the select applications, you can see that we can use this for all of our VR applications, or we can select different applications. Now, Microsoft Flight Simulator is already set up in here, so we just need to go down, highlight Microsoft Flight Simulator, click it, and make sure that you also check the box labeled Enable NIS Scaling. And now we can adjust our scaling for Microsoft Flight Sim. Now, most people that are using the OpenXR Runtime tool are using this render scale set on around 70%. One of the issues with having this render scale set on 70% is you are degrading the image quality that's going to be coming through your headset. And some images can then start to get blurry on you. We're going to make sure that this is on 100. And we're going to leave all the work up to the NVIDIA image scaling tool. So what's going to happen is the NVIDIA image scaler will render the image at a lower resolution and then upscale it back into our VR headset, but it will also add sharpness to the image, thus not degrading the image quality. So once you have this tool, don't be afraid to really crank up the image sharpness. With the image scaling tool, I'm able to keep this at 90%, and I keep the sharpness around 85 or 90%. So as you can see up here at the top, the OpenXR resolution is 3152 by 3084. The only thing that you have to do now is start up your flight simulator and then make sure that you turn the render scale inside of the flight simulator for VR to 100%. If you've downloaded this and decide that, hey, I really don't want this anymore and I just want to get it out of here and I want to make sure that it's removed from our OpenXR developer tool, well, that's pretty easy also. All you need to do is go back to the main installation page, go down to the assets, and re-download your OpenXR scaler tool. Go down and click on that tool, and when it pops up, you're gonna hit run anyway. And then this window is gonna pop up here that's gonna ask you, do you want to repair the scaler tool or would you like to remove the scaler tool? All you need to do is click on remove and then hit finish, and it will take it out of your system. So I hope that explains everything for you, and I hope you get a better VR experience by using this tool. I want to thank everybody for joining us today. If you haven't done so already, make sure you go down below and hit that subscribe and tick that little bell. And to all my flight simmers out there around the world, keep the blue side up, and we will see you on the next one. Thanks for watching, everybody.